my brother Joe took off in a Ford from Kokomo. We hadn't much gas, the tires were low, but that doggone Ford could really go. Along about the middle of the night, we were ripping along like rich folks might, when a Mercury behind me blinked his lights, honked his horn, and he pulled out of sight. We had twin parts in that plunder bus. People might think that I'm in a rut. To you folks that don't dig this kind of jive, it's two carburetors and an overdrive. We made V-spots out of many a town, let the cops' heads spin around and around. They wouldn't chase, they'd run and hide. Me and that Murphy stayed side by side. Now we're Ford men and we likely knew that we'd keep on a racing till something blew. That put feet down like a stuck with glue, through many a town we flew and flew. Down at my lovely bride, her face was blue and I thought she'd died. Them streets through town were 40 feet wide, but me and that Mercury stayed side by side. My brother was pale, said he was sick. He said he was just a nervous wreck, but why should I worry, for what the heck? Me and that Mercury was neck and neck. Now on through the night, we would glide, a flying low to flying wide. Me and that Mercury was taking a ride. We stayed exactly side by side. I looked in the mirror and I saw something coming. I thought it was a plane, but the way it was humming along at a terrible pace. And I knew right then it was the end of the race. When it flew by, I turned the other way. The guy in a Mercury had nothing to say. He was just a kid, just out to play. He was driving a hopped-up Model A.